shows or shares with Khalid the same love with marine operations. Please welcome Mr. Ali Almudahka.
By looking at these two items, can you tell if there are any differences between them? I don't think so. Let me ask another question. Can you tell if these two items are not for use in a drinking water? Again, I don't think so. But I have the answer, and let me tell you what are they. One of these bottles is a glass bottle, and the other one is a plastic bottle. The glass bottle can be reused as many times as we want, but the plastic only used once and thrown away. The glass bottle is environmentally friendly, but the plastic is environmentally harmful and certainly will cause plastic pollution. I know it's a very simple and straightforward example, but have we thought about it? Well, what I'm trying to say here, by applying a small effort to change our behavior, we can make our world a better place for living, protecting our environment and saving our money in a long run. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Captain Ali Almudahka, and in this presentation, I can and I will prove to you that we can implement this method to our oil and gas industry with success. So let's begin with this fact. BBC published in 2013 that 3 million people died, or let's say killed, by the air pollution. In 2015, the number reached 5 million deaths. And recently, the number became 7 million deaths per year. It's a real issue, and we should do something to prevent it. By knowing this fact, let's move to this photo. Can you tell what is this? This is what we call container ship, but not any container ship. This is a very large container ship. And by the way, I have sailed on this vessel. And when we are sailing, we are producing a chemical emissions, and this chemical emissions become the air pollution. To give you a clear picture of the how much emissions that is producing this vessel, let's compare it to our cars. How many cars emissions do you think equal to this large container ship? 1,000 cars? Maybe 10,000? Let's say 100,000. No. This large container ship produces chemical emissions equal to 50 million cars. It's a very huge amount. And by knowing that, that's why latest research found that shipping industry is the largest transport polluter in the world. By telling you this fact, let's move to our field, QP field. QP contracted around 60 vessels that are sailing around Qatar offshore, supplying, maintenance, diving, construction, and etc. To give you a clear picture, this is a satellite photo taken over you. And by the way, this dot is not a fly. Every dot in this photo represents a vessel, and you can see how many they are and how they are affecting our environment by reducing the chemical emission. I have talked about the air pollution. I have another issue, which is the fuel cost. Because the QP, when they contracted with a vessel, they are responsible for the fuel. I did my calculation, take an example of 6 vessels, and the result was QP paying 12 million Qatari riyal per year. And this is only for 6 vessels, only for fuel, not including the contract rate, which is a very high cost. Let's do a recap. We have talked about the air pollution, how it's affecting ourselves, our environment, and the high fuel cost. What do you think? How we can resolve these issues? By the way, no need for you to think I have a solution. That's why I'm presenting. Well, it is very simple and straightforward, similar to my example. Reduce the speed of the vessel. By reducing the speed of the vessels, we are achieving significantly impact environmentally and financially. How? I will tell you. By reducing the speed from service speed to economical speed, which is around 30%, the fuel consumption will be reduced from 20 to 30%. And the chemical emissions will be reduced by 60 to 70%. You can see, by simple solution, we are achieving very high achievement. It is like hitting two birds by one stone. Now, let's move to my calculation. What about if we apply the speed reduction to the six vessels? The cost saving will be 2 million Qatari riyal per year. And what about if we apply it for the rest of the vessels? The cost saving will be 20 million Qatari riyal per year. And in 5-year contract, the total amount will be 100 million Qatari riyal. I know I only talked about the advantages, and I'm sure most of you have an idea what is the disadvantage, which is the delay. Because when we reduce the speed, there will be a delay from location to location. But how long do you think the delay will be? 6 hours? Or let's say maybe 12 hours? Or more to 24 hours? No. It's only 30 to 90 minutes, which is nothing compared to our tangible benefit. Believe me, I'm a captain, and I have sailed for more than 10 years, and this is nothing. Now, in a conclusion, why we should implement my proposal right now? Well, I have three reasons. One, it's simple and straightforward and costs us nothing. Second, it will protect our environment. Third, it will save our money. QP vision, in line with Qatar Vision 2030, that QP to become a world-class NOC, and inshallah we will. And to achieve this high goal, we must have a high standard in health, safety, and environment. And all of this, we are achieving in my proposal. Why I do care? Why I do care about the air pollution that causes diseases? Why I do care about the high fuel cost? Why all of you should care? Why everyone in Qatar should care? Because Qatar deserves better. Thank you.
Very, very organized, and you had an excellent presence on the stage, Ali. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Shall we have questions?
Yes, please.
Any questions?
First of all, I'd like to commend Captain Ali for this excellent presentation. I was very happy and delighted to see and hear this presentation, and very informative. The question is, how do we go about implementing such a procedure? Because I know it's difficult. We have so many ships, local, foreign ships. How do we go about implement? Do we enforce a law? What do we do? Because procedures are the lazy procedures. So what do you recommend?
Thank you for your question. That really means a lot to me. And I'm sure that you are following in my proposal. Thank you very much. Well, gentlemen, he asked if I can repeat the question, this, how we can implement this such flow. Well, actually, in this proposal, I only talked about QP, but my intention actually to be like Qatar as a whole, like it should be by Ministry of Transport, to restrict any vessels that coming to our territorial zone, which is 12 nautical miles, to go by their, what we call, economical speed. Every vessel has their, by manufacturer, the economical speed, which is like a certain amount, which is not same for each vessel. So by that law, we can restrict this air pollution coming to our country. I hope I answered your question.
Thank you, Mr. Khan. Thank you. We have another question there. Mr. Jason.
Assalamu alaikum, good morning. Jason Fakhri, OH Manager Dukhan. Thank you for a great presentation, great confidence in your presentation. Just to double, I know you've went into a lot of the financial calculations.
Yes.